Hark a herald, bump, 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 glory to the bump, bump, bump. Peace on earth, bump, 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 bump.
Why do you doing here?
Well, I live here, Mrs. Mackay.
You should be taking an afternoon nap. I could generally set my clock by the regularity of your habits, both the good and the bad.
Oh, I don't have bad habits, Mrs. Mackay. When you're born into the right class of family, they're really considered to be, eccentricities. The thing is, worked myself up snoring, couldn't get off again.
Aye.
Too much going on up here, don't you see?
Whatever you say, Sultan, I'm sure all your responsibilities are just way awful ahead.
Ah, well, uneasy lies ahead, Mrs. Mackay.
Aye.
Thing is, too many big ideas, thick and fast.
Yes, and in my experience, most of them come from the thicker end of the spectrum.
Don't be such a tease.
Well, if you're wanting me, it's quite out of the question, as I'm all for this evening, sorting out the mountainous problems you've made with your last big ideas.
Well, you carry on, Mrs. Mackay, don't mind me. Quiet as a mouse. Scats on her.
Bom, 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 Merry Christmas. Bom, 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 Merry Christmas. Bom, 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 Merry Christmas, and a bom, bom, New Year.
I say, Mrs. Mackay, have you got a moment, please?
What is it now, Sultan? These constant interruptions are a veritable irritation.
Well, I'm frightfully sorry, but completely unavoidable. But these papers, they're entirely wrong. Entirely the wrong papers.
Well, why don't you attend yourself to some of the others that you've left littered about the place?
Yes, but which ones? You see, I was rather hoping to fine-tune the speech to the RSPB dinner.
You know, I'm surprised they abide you as their patron, considering you spent half your day blasting my clear and tell out of the car. Anyway, that was the function you went to last week.
Oh, good Lord, no. Is it? I mean, I should know. I was there.
That's where I directed the taxi to take you, and I've no doubt that's where it delivered. Do you never look at your diary?
Oh, I'd rather thought that was your partnership, Mrs. Mackay. I can't be expected to remember everything. I'm a peer of the realm.
It's a joint responsibility, and I'd be obliged if you remember that in the future. Anyway, that's the function you went to last week.
Oh, good Lord, it wasn't, was it? Are you sure? I've already delivered that speech.
What? No, you can't have done.
Well, it would explain why it all fell extremely flat. And,
because you should have been... Your next appointment, if I remember rightly, is the British Footwear Association.
Well, that would explain why that joke of mine about their locking a load of old cobblers fell completely flat.
Don't tell me you talk back to the RSPB. What hardly seems appropriate.
Well, I tell you what, Mrs. Mackay, you're just going to have to send a letter of apology explaining it was all your fault.
Mine?
Well, of course. That's the way society works, you see. The upper classes make the mistakes, the middle classes share the burden, and the lower classes suffer the consequences. It's worked for centuries.
I despair. Whatever are we going to do with you? Well, if that's all for now, I'll be getting back to my work.
Yes, you carry on, Mrs. Mackay. In fact, it's about time for a snifter, really. No, we'll overwork myself.
Aye, but you know what I think about drinking at this time of the afternoon.
Don't be such a spoilsport, Mrs. Mackay. Father always insisted that the wheels of government would grind to a halt if they weren't liberally lubricated with alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
Besides, it's Christmas Eve.
And it's no excuse for intemperance the rest of the year. It'll be the death of you, Sir Walton, the death of you.
Oh, well. Guilty as charged. I tell you what, I'll just have this one, and you can take all the other offences into account when you pronounce the sentence. Be a good chap and finish tidying all this mess up, would you?
Well, it was you that made the mess in the first place.
Oh, Grace, just in time to join me, my dear. I'm not all for Christmas.
Quite right, darling. You work far too hard. I've just heard Emma's car arriving. So gin is definitely the order of the day.
And tonic, my dear.
I said Emma has arrived, so a very long, very strong, very straight gin would be absolutely perfect. He's becoming possibly bohemian since you went off to London.
Well, I really wish that you could try a little bit harder with her. You know, she's my only child. Well, so far, anyway.
Well, don't get any ideas on that subject. Childbirth and all the subsequent inconvenience is far too tedious to even think about.
We could get a nanny. Do you know, I was nearly 10 before I knew Mother. She was frightfully sporty, and for years I thought she was a tennis coach. You can imagine my surprise when I found out we were actually related. Go on, what do you say?
Please, Walter, what rather paid help is present?
Personal, private secretary, if you don't mind, Lady Gates. And if it was the payment that was of interest to me, I can assure you I could find far more agreeable remuneration elsewhere.
Oh, please, no take on, sir, Mrs. Mackay. I'm sure it's just a slip of the tongue, wasn't it, my dear?
Yes, of course it was. I'm sure you were an absolute treasure. All of that shorthand and whatever, so terribly clever. Must be so fulfilling to have a trade. Daddy! We're here! This is absolutely ages.
Yes, it's marvellous to see you, my dear. Marvellous to see you.
Oh, hello, Grace. I'm Miss Mackay.
Welcome home, Miss Emma. I hope you had a good journey.
It was terrific. The James drives so quickly. I thought my poor little car's going to explode or something. But it didn't, luckily. Daddy. And this is James. He's just returned from a trip to Africa. Isn't that fun?
James Washington, delighted to meet you, Sally. I know this seems a damned impertinence to force myself upon you like this, but when Emsie found out I was to be alone at Christmas, she absolutely insisted that I join you in your festivities. I hope you don't mind, sir.
Of course he doesn't.
Daddy? No, absolutely. The more the merrier.
Oh, and James, oh, he's astonishingly brilliant. Oh, he's just amazing, really. Well, he's a rock climber, a writer, a botanist, and an anthropologist. Isn't that just stupendous? I can't even spell half the things he does.
I'm a pretty keen photographer as well. But I wouldn't say I'm a fully fledged expert in any of them, really. They seem to muddle myself through. Oh, I simply adore flying.
Really? I'm sure a man of your diverse talents doesn't even require mechanical assistance of aeroplane for that.
Obviously, you must be Lady Gates. Emsie's told me all about you.
Yes, I'm sure she has.
As it happens, the ability to fly unassisted would be of God's sake. Afraid I don't have the own money for my own kite.
James manages all his expeditions with an absolute shoestring. I simply don't know how he does it. The poor man hasn't got a bee to his neck.
Oh, luck in the draw, I'm afraid. Right family, wrong son. Eldest brother got the title and the estate, and middle brother got the cash. And I was left with father's fly fishing tackle and mother's wicked sense of mystery. Wouldn't change it for the world.
That's absolutely splendid, old man. It's a shame you weren't here earlier. Salmon season's closed, I'm afraid. We could have been out and tried for some. We banked absolute monsters last year.
Really? I would have enjoyed that, sir. Once had to survive several months just eating raw fish while I was escaping from some native types in the Amazon.
Raw fish? That's horrid. I'd be sick.
Oh, obviously campfire. Amazing sense of smell those chaps have. Marvellous people. Thought I was cutting along with them quite well, actually, until I saw them looking at my head. Came down to a pretty stark choice. Having cut off and shrunk off. Make myself scarce and too long.
You need to be very wary around here, then. Mrs. Mackay can be terribly fierce. She trim on your head with a glass.
I should think you're fine. The Mackay family has an enviable reputation of light-hearted cordiality, Lady Gates. So it'd be a pleasure if you to reach regularity elsewhere, if you don't mind.
Cordiality, perhaps. But clearly very little sense of humour, I think. That will be all for now. I'm sure you must have lots of vital filing on paper clipping to complete.
So, Walter?
Yes, please, carry on.
That's well. Appreciate no further disturbances, if you don't mind. You may have finished with the festive season, but some of us are still working to look after your vital interests.
Oh, this is the time. Don't take it all so seriously. I say so.
Oh, well.
Ghastly woman. No mistaking Mrs. Mackay for a ray of sunshine.
Don't be so beastly to her, Grace. I honestly don't know how Daddy would cope without her.
Well, it has been some time since he's had any sensible help from within the family. James, please, please tell me. You don't count musicianship amongst your many talents. Emma's guest last year insisted on boring us with his violin. My husband overheard from the adjoining room and imagined we'd acquired a vocal stray cat.
Quite right, absolutely right. Yes, awful, awful noise, you know. Peculiar chap.
Except, Daddy wasn't her husband then. Mummy hadn't been dead for very long.
Yes, let's not dwell on the past, my dear. It's always best to move forward, you know. Best foot forward, chin up, stiff upper lip.
But Daddy, it was Hoyt. It's our first Christmas without her. And soon after, we had an intruder. Yes, who broke in. And beat Daddy nearly half to death with his own cricket bat.
Dashed unsporting. Dashed unsporting.
I'm rather an exaggeration, Emma, darling. A broken leg might not be much fun, but it certainly isn't life-threatening.
Well, it's the worst cricket injury I've ever had. Had a few blows to the old pate in the past, but didn't seem to affect me in any way. Not that anybody would notice, anyway.
Why don't you open the bowling and batting for the county with my schedule at house, son? Nothing quite beats the sound of leather or willow, is there, sir?
Absolutely. Music to the old ears. I say, do you two want to join us in a drink?
Oh, yes. Beautiful for me, please, Daddy. And the same for James. Now, as our guest, you must help yourself and be a careful one. As long as you don't get too scriffy.
Absolutely. Except, of course, my visit to Malton's unit special dispensation to touch no less.
Now, we must find you something soothing to my James. Oh, Mummy was so much fun. At Christmas, she absolutely insisted that everyone should wear a fancy dress. Oh, the times we had! We used to roar with laughter.
I really don't think I'd want to continue with that nonsense, Emma, darling. It's all far too tedious for words.
Daddy, tell her.
Oh, come on, my dear. It's that seasonal joviality.
Fine, darling. If you must. Far be it from me to interfere in the running of my own household. Lord knows what that brother of yours will wear. He wears far enough, he's ridiculous enough as it is.
Oh, I say, that's supposed to be a bit of a surprise.
Daddy's brother? Uncle Archie? He's actually here?
Yeah, it's pitched up yesterday, completely out of the blue.
Oh, wow! All the way from Australia? How amazingly brilliant! Oh, what's he like?
Well, Antipode and Bumpkin would sum him up more magically. He seems to have heartily embraced the Australian culture. One would ever call it that.
Oh, I've been absolutely been dying to meet him for years. Mummy and Daddy were going to visit him last year, but Mummy...
I really fail to comprehend what you and Elizabeth are thinking of, darling. As far as I can gather, James, he's a parasitic ne'er-do-well. He's been scratching off my husband for the past 30 years.
Well, no, not exactly off me, my dear. I mean, the father set up a trust fund for him for so he could have a regular income when he sent him off to Australia.
Despite the fact that he packed him off to Australia in disgrace, the foibles of your family will never cease to amaze you, darling. So when do you ever manage to acquire any wealth at all?
Ah, well, you see, in a family of breeding, it's de rigueur to have a Roman stuck in the background somewhere. Anyway, none of us are getting any younger, and Elizabeth insisted that I go and make things up with him.
And after Mummy died, I was determined to take her place and travel all the way to Australia with Daddy. What a stupendous adventure that would have been. But Daddy's broken leg paid her wrong plans.
You're an adored engine. There's nothing quite like the sight of Ayers Rock from the back of a camel at dawn.
And now he's beaten you all to it. And landed on our doorstep out of the blue like a very bad penny. Oh, what joy.
Now, let's not be churlish about it, my dear. Best thing is just knuckle down and get on with a good old-fashioned family Christmas.
So
sublime, I can hardly wait.
So where is he?
Well, he said he was going off on a walkabout, whatever that is. I've no doubt he'll be back pretty soon. All of which jolly well reminds me. Mrs. Mackay, do you have a minute, please?
Aye, what is it, salt and another of your emergencies?
Oh, absolutely, top priority. I tasked you with digging out some of those photographs of me and Archie. What progress?
I will scour the orchestra top to bottom and there's no sign of them, none at all. Are you sure you didn't put them in the old nursery room with all the other family junk?
Junk? That's not junk, Mrs. Mackay. That represents generations of family history. Stretching right back to when we actually had to work for a living. You'll just have to join me in the search, I'm afraid.
No,
but Mrs. Mackay, absolute top priority.
Oh, and me, please, Daddy. I'll help. And you must come too, James. It's an absolute Aladdin's cave up there. Full of amazing treasure.
Love to, and he loves to, but to be quite honest, I'm a bit whacked from yesterday's rugger game. We had two chaps sent off, and I had to cover both wings and the hooker. Do you mind if I just sit down here and relax with my drink? Oh,
don't worry, Emma, darling. I'll look after him. I promise I won't eat him. Kill him, maybe. Slap him almost certainly.
Kiss him, perhaps.
What the hell are you doing here, James? Two bad pennies in the space of 2 days is simply beyond belief.
Gracie, come on, is that the way to greet an old friend?
3 years, James. It's been 3 years since you walked out of my life.
Please, let's not go through that again. We agreed it was impossible. All you ever wanted was money and a life of comfort. I couldn't give you that.
Couldn't or wouldn't? Too busy dashing off, performing manly deeds of daring do.
Oh, Gracie, don't let's argue. Your dreams come true. Don't begrudge me following mine.
My dream? You think I enjoy this? James, I hate it. I detest it. Married to that man? You think that's a dream?
But you chose.
Yes, I chose. Bad choice, as it turns out. But then that's not your problem, is it? Nothing was ever your problem.
Gracie, don't let's be angry with me. I can't bear it.
James, I'm not angry with you. Not really. Yes, I despised you when you walked out of my life. But that was my big mistake. That was when I plotted and schemed my way into Walton's life. My success would somehow be your failure. Oh, Walton's a good man. A kind man. But I'm afraid I'm beginning to loathe him. His ridiculous manner. His awful laugh. So, James, welcome to my world. Heaven on the outside, but on the inside, I feel my soul is descending into hell. I know I'm turning into some kind of a monster, but I just can't help myself. And now you turn up here with Emma. Is that some kind of a sick joke? We detest each other.
Oh, Oh, she's not so bad. She means well, but she's not my type at all. We met at a friend's party, and then I realised who she was. Maybe I was wrong, but when she invited me here, I couldn't resist to see you one more time. Look, if you want me to leave...
Oh, no, James, that's the last thing I want. To tell you the truth, when you walked into the room, my poor little heart started pounding like anything. But I just don't see what good can come of you being here.
You're opening old wounds, Gracie. If only you knew how much I've missed you. Did you really mean what you said about Sir Walter?
James, if I could afford to walk out tomorrow, I would.
So what if there was a way out of all this dreadful mess that I've created, where we could both lead the lives that we wanted, but together forever?
Oh, James, stop it. That's impossible.
I've spent my whole life attempting the impossible. I just need to get my hands on your husband's mind. We need to talk. Is there somewhere where we could go where we could not be disturbed for a while?
I could show you to your room, and I'll make it as far away from Edmund's as is possible.
There's no need to worry on that score. I've been the perfect gentleman as always.
That's not how I remember you.
Oh, Gracie, there's only ever been one girl for me. Come on, let's go before the others come back. Hello, knock knock, hello. Gong ding dong, the old pie. In Devon, the bells are ringing.
Jesus.
In fact, I've been here ever since I was a small boy.
Oh, and you're Santa. And what fun.
Oh, don't be fooled by this lifelike costume. I'm not the real Santa.
I realise that.
And I haven't got you a present, if that's what you were hoping.
Oh, easily of you. Do you fancy the chimney?
No, no. Don't be deceived, madam. Underneath this bulbous coat is the body of a finely horned
No, the present's too fat for.
But I have bought you one.
No. Look, I don't want to be a bore, but do you think we could start again?
But from where?
From the beginning, perhaps.
Oh, good idea, madam. You seem a little cohesive. I'll reiterate my entrance. Donding murder me up, am I?
Yes.
Hello, I'm Sergeant Pratt, and I'm soliciting for the Retired Police Officers Malevolent Fund.
Oh, I understand now. Oh, how silly.
Oh, no, they're not silly. They've dedicated many years to public servitude.
No, me, I'm silly. I thought you were someone else.
Yes, Santa, it's a lifelike costume, isn't it? I was going to come dressed as Good King Wendy's ass, but I'm too legs short of a full donkey.
Oh, well, look, I haven't got any money to hand, but...
Oh, no, begging would be criminally offensive. No, what I'm offering is my touring pathetic magic show.
Oh, wow. Magic? How incredible. I do so love magic.
Oh, then well, you've come to the right man. I'm a master of delusion. Observe. A burble off your tree. I shall place it in my handkerchief like so. This is your fantasy. Place it on the table like so. Abracazebra. I think it'll be all right. Allow me to introduce my assistant.
Yes, stupendous.
Puddle, get yourself in here at the bubble. Come along.
It's Potter, Sarge!
Oh, well, then we haven't got time for all that. Come on.
Hello, he's really awful, isn't he?
I shouldn't have to dress up like this. It's my day off.
Normally, for my theatrical delusions, I employ the services of an attractive, intelligent young lady. I'm afraid Constable Potter is all right to find a short notice. You will note that she's dressed as the Archangel Gabriel.
That's just brilliant. Remember that? Which is the fairy.
See, I told you. It's not fair making me dress up like this.
I'll tell you what's fair, little. Anyway, when would you like me to fall?
Oh, look, I don't want to take advantage of you like anything, but would I be a frightful bore if I asked for you to perform in front of everyone this evening? Oh. It would be the most amazing fun.
Oh, really? You mean I would have a complete conflagration of you?
You have to make the arrangements with Sir Walton first. I'll send you through, shall I?
Through what? Oh, I see. I'm very well. Can I borrow your telephone? And I mean by borrow it, I don't want to take it anywhere. I just want to talk to it.
As you wish, Sergeant.
And in the circumstantials, please feel free to refer to me with my theatrical nom de plume, the incredible Puzzled Pratt.
Wow. The incredible Puzzled Pratt.
The Pratt.
Yes, that's what I said. Pratt. Oh, just stupendous.
Oh, come on, Sarge. We really have to stay until later. It's Christmas Eve, I'm going to go and have a bath and wash the hair.
And that's exactly why I'm against women being recruited into the police force. I mean, you should be happy that you're out and about and not stuck in the station making cups of tea.
Well, I shouldn't have to make tea all the time. I think I'd be pretty good at solving things.
Lady policeman solving things, whatever next. It all started going wrong when you were given the universal suffering to vote. Anyway, you're staying here to help me, Pibble. I has had a romantic evening planned with Mrs. Pratt.
Cool,
but she's devastated to miss that. Oh, hello, my love. It's George. George. Your husband, George. Yes. I'm afraid there's been a change of plan. Work, I'm afraid. Oh, you're wearing your best flannelette nightie. Well, sure, you look very erratic, my love. Yes, well, I'm afraid something's just popped up. Oh. I mean, cropped up. Yes, a slight change of plan. Yes, yes. Oh, well, you don't need to take that amplitude. No, oh, no, I'll be lucky. Yes. Just you get those sprouts on the gas before I get home, woman. Hello?
Looks like you'll be on the sofa tonight.
No, Mrs. Pratt is a very understanding woman. She had got the hats off to bed for an early night. She had plans for me to stuff her turkey.
You're right, here you go.
Thank you, Paul.
I'll see you tonight.
Good to you too, sir.
Didn't expect to see Santa here so soon. Chrissy won't be here for a few hours yet, mate.
I wasn't even aware that Chrissy lived here.
I think he means Christmas, Sarge.
It must be Santa's ill help, right? Tell you what, you'll be out any time you like if you think you
Yeah, I think I do, sir.
Come up and give me your Chrissy later if you like. I've been as good as gold all year, more or less.
Excuse me.
Oh, what's you done, mate?
No, it's your trousers.
What about, mate? Right?
Around the back.
Oh, quietly. Let's hear that. Oh, well, hey, back in us, we call that the big outback. Hey, get it? Big outback, yeah? Suit yourself. Anyway,
play, Sarge, Mrs. Constable Pobble.
It's Potter, Sarge. And I've been attended to by a very nice lady. Thank you very much, sir.
Ah, well, that'd be Lady Gates. Bit of a stunner, eh? I understand why she'd want to marry a senile old duffer like my brother. Ah, speak of the devil.
Ah, oh, Archie, there you are. you must be this Pratt fellow.
Yes, well, retired police officer's malevolent fund.
You mean malevolent?
Quite so, yes, and frightfully philanthropic.
Oh, no, we're not collecting stamps, just a few magic tricks.
I see. Do you chop people in half, that sort of thing?
No, I perform a wide range of conjugal skills. But to Hallmark's the soaring half routine from the act owing to an unfortunate accident with Mrs. Pratt's sister.
Good Lord, you didn't kill her, did you?
No, fortunately, my quick-wittedness averted a fatality, although her left leg was in jeopardy for some time.
Stroke! I managed to save it,
eh? Oh, luckily, yes. It's pickled in a jar.
I may make a remark, Sir Walton.
Oh, Mrs. McCartney, yes, please, fire away.
From all the evidence so far presented, I'm not sure I would engage this fellow.
It's for a very good cause, sir. If you don't want, we could get off home.
You ask me, what? Well, I've just got a kangaroo loose in the top paddock. I am sure he's that safe to have around.
I assure you I'm as safe as a hearse. In fact, my recent application to the Magic Circle was only narrowly rejected by unanimous decision.
Extraordinary.
However, I can offer you my nativity show. I start off with the Immaculate Contraption, followed through by the visitation of the three blind men, carrying gold, Frankenstein, and manure.
It's myrrh, Sarge.
Yes, well, I think we'll just stick with the magic show, shall we? How does two guineas sound to you?
Oh, no, I prefer English currency, sir.
Very good. £2, then?
Oh, that's very generous. When would you like to start?
That's a question. Let me see. I say, how about an hour? It gives them all a chance to freshen up.
Oh, very good. Well, there is one administrative matter to take care of before I begin.
Oh, Mrs. Mackay takes care of all that sort of thing from my end. I'm sure she'll assist you.
Well, if that's what you want, Salton. But the wand, the man's a charlatan. No more than a charlatan.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Mackay. What's the worst that could happen? Oh, I tell you what, you can stay and watch the show as well. It'll be a treat for you. Come on, Archie, let's get out from under this fellow's feet. I'll take you out through the conservatory and introduce you to Emma.
No worries, Walt. I'm all behind you. I'll have to change these strides, though. I'll snag them on your barbed wire fence.
Well, I hope you won't be keeping my long, Sergeant. I need to be about my business. I've got a very heavy schedule.
Constable Kibble can help you with that later. Artish has helped me with all my equipment for the car.
What? All of it? By myself? What about you?
Yes, me. I'm going to take a stroll in the fresh air to compost myself. Ready for my performance.
Right you are, Sarge. Whatever you say.
Now, let's begin, Mrs. Bankley. Could you please pass in this highly secret note to the lady of the house?
Oh, well, that would be Lady Gates.
Oh, Lady Gates.
I might as well ask what it's about.
No, I cannot divulge the nature of my secretion. Suffice it to say that she will be randomly selected to assist me in my climatic finale. Can I rely on your suggestion?
I suppose so. Will that be all?
Oh, I agree.
Then I'll pass it on to her when I next see her.
Go on.
Oh.